Hey there, guys, gals, fans, and pals. Your buddy John Megacycle here. Another episode of Vulcanoids coming at you. My game is starting to stutter a bit here. Oh, nope, we're good. That was weird. Nope, can't go there. Moving up our way through the tech tree pretty solidly, I'd say. I'm really happy with how far we... Ooh, that was close. That was stupid close. Moving up the tech tree real nicely, I was trying to say. Things are moving real well. Ooh, a level 3. Yeah, we'll tussle that. Ooh, sensors. And we're full. It says the drill ship took damage, but it's not going to tell me what took damage. That's kind of one of the things that bugs me a little bit about this game. Is stuff can take damage. I wish it was like a damage readout that said, hey, here's a picture of your ship. These are the things that need repairs. And that way I'd spend a lot less time screwing around with trying to find what's busted. And, you know, more time fixing, less time searching. It's kind of the deal. Oh, get that. Awesome. Moving on up, moving on up. We're gonna mess up some dudes. Ugh. Right now I'm just looking for tech and for parts and for all the fun stuff I need for upgrades and such. Right now it's fairly tame action right now, but we've got some good armor. We've got 74 of these bombard pieces or whatever you want to call them. Things are looking good. So I want the one on the... So the one on the right looks like another production ship. Which I've already got everything I need out of production. The one on the left looks like a generic, holy crap, security ship? Yeah, this is awesome. I can now deal critical damage to jerks that are not near me. Hi. Nope. Aim for their feet. That's kind of the rule when you're dealing with explosives. If you aim for the head, the shot can kind of just whiz right past. But if you aim for the feet, hopefully the explosive area will just do the work for you. Yep, keep firing, stupid. Good chat. Okay. Now with this, I can actually start dealing damage on the way. Ooh, I got somebody. There's a lot of somebodies. The whole mess of somebody's. Holy crap. There we are. How you doing? Yeah, John Megacycle here. Another episode of I'm Gonna Kick Your Ass. Okay, a mortar cannon. Which I want to handle first. And I want to enter this way. Come on. Really? How many shots do you need, buddy? One more? There we are. There's the money make. There's the money make right there. Okay. Lots of grenades. Wow. I hear them. Okay, I want that. I want that. I want all of that. And that. And that. And that. And that. And that looks good. Okay, now I'm gonna come up here. We're gonna re-armor. I don't think I'm gonna have a ton of opportunities to re-armor, and because I'm taking so much less damage, I can actually be a little gentle about this. Okay. Yep. Want these turrets out of here. Energy low. Oh no, he knows. I'll have to deal with that sometime this year, but not right now, clearly. You dead, sucker? There we go. We clear? Yep, we clear. Okay, next thing. Explosives are so good because the drill ship is so compact. Can you hear them? He's shooting through the floor. What a jackass. Oh, that's where they all were. Nothing good. Nothing good. I will want to stay up here as much as possible. Let's take this thing out one chunk at a time. Want to aim a little high so some of the shockwave of the battle actually replicates against the wall. That's a turret. Okay. Drill ship, I love you, baby, but I can't do a damn thing about that right now. There's so many bodies down there. I'm actually running low on Kabang Bang. I don't even know from what angle I'm getting shot at. Chuck that downfield. And actually, the good thing is I found a bunch of grenades. This is going to be a nil issue. Good there. Yep, I'll take that. There are so many bodies. I'll definitely take those two items. Oh, I'll take that. Take that. Take that. I'll take that. Sure, more mortar grenades, awesome. Really? I missed? You know what, I wonder if all the dead bodies are starting to act as a buffer zone for damage. That faded away or something? Oh, they probably have a natural decay rate. Okay, did we get everything here? I believe we did. You know, if you could warn me about that a lot less often, that would be super. Ooh, multi-kill. Yoink, I need those boilers, baby. Yoink. Oh, hi. yoink. I knew this was gonna be like ridiculous amounts of fun, and it has not disappointed. Oh, I need that and that. Is there a sensor in there? Oh, whatever. Dunk. What is even happening here? Did I get him? I did not get him. There we go. Now I got him. Alright. Get these turrets out of here. Two more pieces. Alright. Anything else off these bodies? I don't need any more of that. Stack. All the grenades in the world. I have all the grenades in the world. This is nuts. I think we're good. Did that not hit anything? What? Yep. It happened again. It literally happened again. It didn't make the ooga. Oog. It didn't make the noise. Thank goodness I was paying attention. I'm like, I think I got everything. I really do. And then I realized I really did. Alright, what do we got? Level 3 treads, sure. Oh, okay, okay. Happy birthday. Throw the grenade. Oh my god, do you see that? There's a whole fleet of them. Now there's a whole dead of them. I don't think I need any of these parts. I was really hoping for refining modules. But all I'm getting are production modules. That's okay. So I picked up about, I'd say 8 or 10 mortar shells, and I only have 3 left. Not including the one that's in the chamber. So we went through about 80 or something mortars? Something ridiculous, right? Yeah. Not too bad of a haul. Walking away with a lot more tech. Not the tech I need. I might actually have to fight a tier 2 science or a tier 2 refinery. Well, actually, we've been finding a lot of sensors. Sensors are a tier 2 thing, so that might work out nicely. To solve our power problem, first gut check answer is we'll just add more power. I don't really want to do that. What I want to do is I need a device for turrets. Think that's what I want. You can have the boilers and the ammo. I'll take this. I'll show you how this works. I could instead go to every single turret and shut them off like this. That reduces how much power is required, also opens up some core modules. What I can do instead is I could do this, and that'll shut all the turrets. Now that should give us a much better draw on power, right? Because that opens it up. So plus 50, so minus 20, plus 15. Yeah, that frees up 8 power. We're still not positive though. P2 power. P2 power. Are we out of coal? We're absolutely bone dry out of coal. That's our issue. Okay, and I don't think I have any coal stashy stashed. No. Rats. Okay, I don't really want all these grenades. Okay, let's boogie a little bit. Or wait, was there coal here? Oh, there's coal here. Cancel, 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 cancel. Let's go do some mining. Ugh. Smell all that rich air. Just breathe it in. Ugh. Good for the heart, good for the soul. Pride of the working class. Game is a little stuttery. I'm sure it's showing up in the recording, but maybe with so many dudes we're spawning in or forcing to be spawned, maybe that's causing some issues. Because if you check the first two episodes, I think we didn't have any stuttering whatsoever, but we're having just some minor stutters. And I'm calling it out now because it might be, instead of it being like part of the rendering process, but every like 6 seconds or so. Yeah, now we're fine. Just harvest this up real quick, like. Well, that should be more than plenty to keep us going. Another thing that I wish the game would kind of represent better is the reason for why stuff's busted. In this case, hey, low power. So you gotta do a little bit of digging. It doesn't make it that big of a deal. Yeah, we're way good now, for sure. Those turrets had to get shut off regardless, but we're way better now. That goes in. Don't need that. Don't need that. That can come in. That and that. That, that, and that. That and that. And that and that. Drillship storage full. Of freaking course, because I went ape crap. Okay. Looking good, looking good, looking good, looking good. Science. Hi. T3. How much production T3 do I have? T1, T2, T3. I don't need any of these. That's two slots I just freed up. Didn't need it at all. Had enough. Hydraulics are going to give us T2. I don't need extra four. That can go away. That's another slot I just cleared out. Transmissions we'll need. Sensors we'll need. I don't need any of those. Destroyed refinery module T2. And boilers and shredders. Okay, let's pound that out into a level one science. There we go. And then what else do we have here? Destroyed research module T2 that gets converted right into T2 research tech. That's easy. Yep, two of that. Alright. I think we got our stuff, like, on point. I think when it really comes down to it, when I gotta go mess up some fools, I think we've got it going on real, real smooth. I need more copper. Because I am out of stuff to make more mortar shells, which is unfun-fortunate. Yep, I got all the production research I'll ever need for the rest of the game, and all of the modules I'll need. All the extra bits I'll need, anyway. Where are we on upgrades? Oh yeah, T1 engine, copper hull. Can we get level 3 stuff yet? Alloy T2 ingot, that's easy. Alloy T1 ingot, that's easy. Alloy T1 ingot, that's easy. I need 12 T1s. And 10 T2s. Okay, what are we missing? We're low on iron. Ugh, am I just straight out of iron again? I thought we got a bunch of iron. Yeah, okay, I sifted it out. Yeah, I totally did that. Okay. Boop, boop, ba-doop. That'll give us T3 drill, T2 hull, T2 engine, T3 tracks. Can we just shift right over to that as well? Because I have T3, yeah, T2 tracks. Let's do that. Oh, today's our upgrading session. Alloy, T2. That should be enough for all that. And now we just have to wait for the production to just do its due. Any new schematics I need to pay attention to? This guy, 15 diamond. Okay. Once we get the T3 drill, we'll be able to go muck around with Dasmans. 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 10 T1s. What? Didn't I make a bunch of... Didn't I already do the T1s? 7. Don't know why that says 7. Thank you very much. Building a nice little stack of modules in case we lose something mid-combat or whatever. Those look like correct numbers to me. Yep, we'll have a nice engine, a better hull, a better drill, better treads. Oh, this is already... Oops. Well, I'm gonna have two hulls now. Okay, that's what took it. That's what took those three... Ah, it's stupid. I'm an idiot. Storage full, eh? That, I guess? And that? Ooh, yeah, we got titanium for days. 4 days! Not gonna use level 1 buckshot anymore. Absolutely no reason to use it. Grenades. Grenades are cute. Not really pulling the weight that I want them to, though. Actually, let's look damage for damage. Mortar grenades are 70 hit points. How much are regular grenades? 50 to 100. What did I say, 70? I meant 60. Explosion radius, 4 meters. Explosion radius, 4 meters. Okay, so the grenades are potentially much more powerful. The thing that we get with mortar grenades, though, is a delicious amount of range. Which, you know, kind of is a big deal. Okay, we're short on diamonds. This is just going to take time. Do we have an upgrade that's done? Awesome. Level 2 engine. Level 2 engine gives us the ability to have another segment, which is cool. I don't think I'll muck around with a third segment, honestly. Oh, you know what? I'll probably have to, because once we break into T3 stuff, I don't think I'll have enough room. I definitely won't have enough power. So I'll have to do another segment, which is fine. Our drill ship segment, please. Yeah, drill hull. Yeah, drill hull segment. And then that third drill is what's going to allow us to move into the next area. So that's awesome. We're moving along. Some of these battles I'm looking forward to. Like, I'm a bit anxious. I'm excited. But I'm also a little terrified. Because with the amount of shenaniganry we've got going on, it's just a little intimidating, to be fair. We're short on what? Sulfur. A lot. And iron. I think I tapped all my iron. Which is fortunate. We have a little bit of iron. Are we on copper? Let's pull two of those out. Okay. Everything nice and repaired. Especially this floor. This floor right here. Pretty critical, because as I mentioned before, if we lose that, we lose everything that we've built on the floor. Could be bunks. I haven't actually built any bunks yet. But could be bunks, could be storage bins, could be anything. Yeah. I'm pretty stupid happy with ourselves here. This has been a lot of ridiculous chaos fun, yeah? How are we on coal? I've got a little time to kill. 48. Yeah, let's do. Let's bother with it. It'll be one less thing I gotta screw with. So, copper, sulfur, iron. Copper, sulfur, iron, and then diamonds. And that'll get us to a hardy tech 3. What'll most likely have to happen, though, before any of that, is I'm gonna have to fight another drill. Wouldn't mind a little excess coal as well, so I'll put in the effort now. Oh! Okay. I'm kinda used to playing games like 7 Days to Die. Let's just do it this way. 20, 40, 60. That way it only eats 3 slots. I'm used to playing games like 7 Days to Die, where you can kind of clip through the door after you've said to the door, "Hey, open please." I'm gonna wait till the drill is done, hopefully. Wait, how much percent is left? Nope. That's not gonna happen. Now, with this little device here that I said really helps us save on power, because I can just shut off all of my turrets. We can turn on one, or shut off one, or turn them all on. And these little console thingies are also good for production structures, or refining structures, or science structures. I think there's a variant for every single one of them. And the second we're underground, the sirens will stop. Yep, just like that. Just like that. Alright, sulfur. Sulfur, sulfur, baby. Sulfur's the deal. So we're gonna head back. Could probably go up a level. Is there an up level around here? There is. I think sulfur will be a little bit more prevalent up there. But as we go raid another base, what's gonna be amazing about all this is we're gonna be smelting down all the stuff. We're gonna get more munitions. Oh, wow. Just give me all the sulfur. Awesome. Yeah. I need it. I'm gonna make a lot more boom boom. Ooh, okay. That was close. By boom boom, I don't mean going to the bathroom. Like, I throw a thing, it go boom. Okay, something took damage. Was that it? Is it this module again? No. I think it's just some random module, and if you stay in the fire for too long, a module just explodes, and then if you stay too long in the fire after that, you explode. Kind of one of those things. Oh, I need more refiny tech. We could actually probably double back now. Hold on. Yoink. I honestly don't mind the drill. Yep, just like that. I don't know if you noticed it, but everything just instantly refreshed. So that's kind of the importance of these explosives, of these explosive events with the volcano, is we could just get piles and piles of resources for no effort. But it really speeds up the game quite a bit. And we're gonna get that. And that'll hopefully max out our T1 stuff. Yeah, get that copper, baby. Boom! Oh, 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 oh. Okay, I got it. Cool. Alright. We have copper, we have iron. Let's get a little more iron. Cool. We have copper, we have iron. We have sulfur for days. Oh, I'm actually incredibly full of stuff. So here's what we're gonna do. I want to spend as little time screwing around with doing what we're doing here as possible. Like I've said before, this is an interesting concept for resource collection and allocation and everything, but to me, this isn't really the crux of the game. The combat, the modifying your ship, that's kind of where the action is. But this is a neat little mini-game here. And it's definitely an interesting take on getting resources started. Let's just maximize our time. This is a little dead zone here we can use. Yep, that is full to the freaking gills. And once we're topside, I'll be able to figure out how much T1 research I have. For smelting technology or refining technology, because that's what I need. Yep. MCV deployed. I present to you the MCV. And you're full already. Awesome. Refinery station. All that. Do that first, please. Storage full, okay? As was proclaimed by the ancients, my storage is full. Yep, I have stupid amounts of stuff. Bill's almost done. What are you waiting on? Oh yeah, right, diamond, which I can't do bupkis about. I don't have anything queued up back here, do I? Look at that. All this work. All this work is just being done, and I don't have to do dink about it. That's amazing. I love it. Alright. Corundum drill. Awesome. That helps. That really, really helps. I don't need these drill parts anymore. That can scram. Tracks and hull. How are we on tracks and hull? Oh, that's right. So we're working on Tech 2 hull, another drill segment, Tech 3 tracks require production module level 3, we are not that far yet, I need diamonds for that. Did all our sulfur just get consumed immediately? Wow, that's nuts. There, I have all the sulfur. All the sulfur, my boy. I don't seem to have any Tech 1 refinery modules. So, hey, how you doing? All of that, thank you. These can get scrammed. Aight. Things be looking good. Things be looking real good. Boop. Take some copper, take some iron. Nice. I have gems somewhere, don't I? Yep, crystals, whatever. And thunk. Organize that up a little bit because that's gonna drive me bananas. Bananas! How's our storage? Two storage modules in addition to your drill ship storage. Kind of seems like to be a happy medium for me. It'd be a lot of fun to add way more storage, but if your storage component gets kabang-banged, the problem is I think you lose everything in the storage. Like, everything. Like, it's not a happy situation. So what I would like to do is I like to add, like, one or two more of these level one storages and just kind of keep them as empty as possible. The benefit of that is, in case one blows up, I think all the items just sift over. Level 2 hull. And what else is being cooked up? Or I think that was it. Oh, a drillship segment. Yep, I want that. It's going to add a lot of territory. A lot of space, a lot of everything. Get this copper smelted down, please. Got, what, 19 minutes? I have a lot of smelting here. I want to, like, do the, I'm just going to sit here and smelt conversation for, like, in between episodes. I don't want to waste a ton of your fine time here. Messing around with just me sitting here with my thumbs twiddling. Thumbs a-twiddling. We have more kabang-bang. I need that. I need that. It sets us up with 75 of those. I would like to chuck all this iron somewhere. I can't really. Let's just go on another raid real quick here. Device. Give me some of that, please. Just one is fine. That will apply. Can I get a few more rounds? That'll do. Now that'll do. One more for good luck. And one more to even the stack? Awesome, thanks. Let's go. Moving on up, moving on up to the east side, moving on up. We got titanium, we got copper, we got iron, we got crystals, we have a ton of stuff to smelt. Things are good. Things are real, real good. Good chat, I'm already gone. Hi! Upgrade? Where does this go? Yep, okay. So now we've got big ol' big segment. And that last segment we had is now the butt. The tail end of the caterpillar. Caterpillar. Alright, we have the good drill, we have a better hull. We've got all the stuff we need to proceed to possibly the third area and or the laser. I think we have to deal with another laser before we get to the next area, like, legit. I don't need any of that, I don't think. Now this should be no problem, right? Yeah, much less of an issue. So where is the next area? Oh, okay. Did that scare anyone else but me? Because that looked like that popped out of nowhere. Okay. Destroy laser device to cool down this area. Wish it was obvious where it was, but I don't know where it is. So we'll just have to do a little searching around. Not a big deal. Let's get some refinery modules. That should get us all to level 1 and level 2 refinery tech without an issue. That should be pretty straightforward stuff. Alright, this drill allows me to... Okay, here we go. T3 drill. Thou shalt not pass. And now what we should see is a laser majig somewhere around here, right? Yep, there it is. Okay, I gotta find a landing zone. Now, before we just had grenades. Grenades definitely work against... I need that. Definitely work against the drill. But... the bombard cannon is what I keep calling it. That's maybe not what it is, but I played enough Age of Empires 2. I think they're called bombard cannons. How the heck? You want me to go through all the lava? Okay. That was risky and stupid and stupidly risky, but whatever. Okay, here we go. Dragon's Lair 2. We might have enough time to... Oh my god, look at it. Look at it, look at it. They've got... a welcoming party just for me. Hey, if you jerks could stand in front of the drill, that'd be awesome. I should have probably used the periscope. Oh, please vacate the area and not notice me coming up. That would be great. This could be really bad. Oh, I'm over there. Merp, merp. Oh my god, let me out, let me out, let me out. Why'd they stop firing? I don't care. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go. Other side, other side. Huh. Look at them all! Okay, you know what? Drill ship, go down. Yep. You can force your drill ship to go down with you not in it. But this is... this. I'll lose my whole ship. Okay, now what I've bought myself is a fair amount of time. And the drill ship will come up when I care. To. Oh my god, look at all this! They're not... they're, oh, yeah, they're engaging. I don't know if their attack range is just shorter or something, but they don't seem to aggro nearly as much as they used to when I played before. Whatever. Whatever. Counting my blessings and missing my targets. Oh, don't mind me. Ah, I'm just gonna screw up the drill you need to survive and stuff. I think we found, like, a game-breaking glitch. To be completely honest about it. They're not doing anything. Like, when I fight two or three cogs, they are relentless. Like, they will try to murder your face hole. But now these guys are just like, derp. Okay, that one's down. And because bombard, I can actually hit that from here, yeah? Perfect shot! Excellent. Critical hit. Awesome damage. All right, it's already three of the six pieces down. Eat boogers. Blam. I get you with my kablammer. If I can thin the herd, I will thin the herd. Now, how do I get around to the other leg? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay, okay. Maybe just this way? The game engine, whatever's happening... does not appreciate this many assets being generated or firing or anything. Because when I try to see a pile of them, my game stutters like nuts. I didn't think I'd hit anybody with that. But our drill ship is safe. This is one of the things I was also mentioning earlier, that we don't even have to bugger around with defenses. We can just pop out, we get out of the drill ship, pop it back down. Drill ship is 100% immune to damage. Oh. Look at that guy. You deploying or you leaving? It's kind of important for me to know. Bingo bango, right on the nose. Yeah. I think I'm getting it. Maybe not. Okay, well, we've got some shots. Oh! I see him fall out of the sky. Always aim at the ground if you need, or if you can, I should say. There we go. Publisher's clearinghouse call. Thunk. Oh. See, I aimed for his chest. And I completely missed. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah, no, tell me all about it, buddy. I'd like to hear what you have to say. Yep, I'm a listening type. I'm a listening type Pokemon. Yep, and Kerthunk. And Kerthunk. And Kerthunk. Cool. Now the last leg on this side should be the last one I need, yeah? Oh, you got a mortar over there too, huh? Telegram. More shots? Yes! Oh yeah. I get no frames because everything just expires. Oh, see, that drill dozer is dead, but it's leaving. So that's how it works. When you take out the drill, all the cogs die. But also what happens is the drill ships vacate the area. So you can't harvest the corpses. Or the husk, or the shell, or whatever you want to call it. Oh man, my game is still stuttering real, real bad. Yeah. Apparently jumping is a problem. But just like before, this is not the first time this happened. We just have to wait, I don't know, 15, 20 seconds. And it'll all clear itself, or it'll clear itself when the volcano happens. Okay, so now... Oh my god, it's still really, really bad. So my drill ship is burrowed right over there. So if I hold G, what should happen is it should come to me and raise up. Yep, coming to Dragon's Lair 1. That is some really cool stuff. I like that. Where are you going? Okay, because if we go here, yeah, it has to go all the way around to avoid all the lava, right? Okay, cool. I need to GTFO, so I'm not in the middle of the kill zone. But that was alright. So, that gets us to our next step for diamonds. Diamonds will unlock our next step of tech. And yeah, this is progressing really nicely. I'm having a lot of fun with this. This is probably my new favorite way to play the game. Maybe some tweaking. Maybe give the cogs a little more damage resistance instead of 200%, maybe 150. Maybe something like that. Maybe lower my damage resistance a bit. I don't know. Do I need sensors? I have level 1 tech. I have only one level 2 tech. And sensors are a level 2, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's go 6. I'm going to dump these two in there. Scrap. Bolts, tubes. Hydraulics. How many hydraulics do I have? I already had 10. Nuke. Technician head. What do technician heads give me? Actually, I don't have to answer that question. Oh, if it gives me Intel Prod Tier 2. Maybe? Yep. I think I needed 3, so that means 6. 6 is right there. Thunk. I don't need any more ammunition than I can carry. Nah. Cool, right? Binary module T2. That's gonna pound out all into T2 tech. Awesome. Yeah, it's filling out our tech reservoir very nicely. Next thing is diamonds. Everything is still smelting like crazy. Let's do a diamond run. I don't need more tech 2 hull. Right? But I already just threw it out, so it doesn't much matter if I needed it or not. tech 3 treads, tech 3 hull. Not that far yet, but let's get going. With our new unlocked area, I would like to do a little bit of diamond hunting, set up shop, and then what I'll probably do is put a bit of a break in between this episode and the next. As I mentioned before, I don't think it's fun, maybe, to just watch someone do a bunch of stuff that's just gotta get done automagic. So I'll just go ahead and put a bit of a break in between when we set up our shop in our new area versus... Oh, I gotta go this way, right? I knew that because that's where the drill ship came from. I'll put in some time in between us setting up a new shop and then... Oh, go, 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 go! Oh my gosh! That sucked. Okay. Well, that was risky. That's what happens when I get too chatty, I guess. But yeah. I think you get what I'm trying to get at. Put a little break time in between. All the things. Alright, where was that ultra hot area? I think it was over here. I don't need to do any harvesting of any sort. I think I've got 2 chests full of crap that needs to get processed eventually. No real big idea as to when that'll happen. No rush. Ah, diamonds. Oh yeah, this is gonna be great. Come to me. Take and take a bunch. That's probably enough for now. Yoink. We're in Area 3, which is going to have titanium, diamonds, iron, I think a little bit of crystal. But if we really want some of the other resources like sulfur in high abundance, it's sometimes easier if you just go all the way back to the first area and just dig it up. Just easy peasy. Also, we haven't spent nearly any time on the surface. I don't know if you've noticed that. But this game has 3 distinct layers. Well, actually 6. But the 3 main ones are the surface, caves, and caves 2. When we fight the end boss, caves 2 is when that's really going to be a thing. But for right now, I have so much titanium. I need that. That's T3. I think I'm good on diamonds right now. I have how many diamonds? 70? Yeah, that's good pickings. Oh, and of course, just yoink. These are production T3 modules, and I don't believe I have any T3 production tech. So furnaces are important. Destroyed modules are important. Yeah, this is all just stonking great. Okay, we're gonna be a little more careful about that. Now I want to find the area. Okay, that requires the hull, maximum hull. I want to find the area that gives me a place to set up shop. Oh wait, is this it? Huh, I only see 1 point. Awesome. We're gonna go to surface. We have tons of diamonds, which is great. If we didn't have the resources this high, it would just take a lot of time for us to wait for an eruption, go get more stuff. Also, going to the surface has a lot of good materials as well. Hi. I need a new door module. And I need a new door. I really wish there were iron and titanium variants of some of this stuff. But everything is just copper. I need that. Oh, I need to repair this first. I need a breach replacement. So the breach replacement fixes the breach, and then the door, and now the door. Yeah, okay, we're good. I cleaned that up nice. So, what's the plan right now? Hopefully to do some upgrade advanced production. We have diamonds, which can I even do anything with the diamonds? I can. Awesome. So we've got diamonds, we've got a lot of stuff I just need to refine and get patched in. Realistically, that's all I'm going to do for maybe like the next half hour, the next 45 minutes, like just IRL time. So let's stop the recording here because that's just going to be boring without a lot of action. I'm going to see you after I get a lot of this stuff smelted down, and we'll talk about a new battle plan. And that stops. Okay, well, thank you all for joining me. Name's John Megacycle. Another episode of Vulcanoids is in the books. Just go ahead and save real quick. Yeah, thanks again, and I hope to catch you next time. Hey there, guys, gals, fans, and pals. Thanks for checking out my video. I also want to take a moment to thank all my supporters and donators, and if you'd like to join up with me and game with my crew, all the information to get connected is in the description below. Thanks again, and I hope to catch you next time.